why do tinan? Tininay do tinan. But you're not sinning, you can only discern. You see? You can discern. In other words, discernment is a power from the Holy Spirit. Yatagan ka na, grasya na, gisuplayan ka na. But dili nimo makabot ang discerning point unless you study God's Word. Di gihapon na maabot nimo. Wa gihapon may tabo nimo. You see? Dali na po gihapon mada sa mga tinunto sa mga unbelievers o believers without doctrine. Aniya pa? As believers, you are supposed to live a supernatural life. Just imagine, your life is supernatural. That's why being a supernatural life, it requires supernatural method of execution. Supernatural. Kiningi mo karon, nagibuhat. You know? Kiningi mo gibuhat karon, di ba, wabakang ka makaanggo. I think Ed is here. Wabakang kaanggo na kiningi mo gibuhat is a supernatural way. Wabakang kaanggo daw. Ha? Tingali mo kaanggo. Kini lang imong pag-anhi-anhi kada simana all the way from faraway place. Ha? Kining imong pagsakripisyo, tingali na kay ubang mga glakaw pa, imo ginagyatagan o pasiyonan, priority. This is supernatural. Why? I repeat, your life as a believer is supposed to be supernatural, which requires supernatural method of execution. That's the only way to live a supernatural life. Because once you make it as your life, because the Word of God becomes your life, Christ becomes your life, and He's a wonderful friend who will never turn back. He will never be unfaithful to you. He is a faithful friend forever, as long as you stay within His sphere of power, power of the Holy Spirit. That's why the Christian way of life is a supernatural way of life, being a mental attitude life. Mental. Don't you know? O Diyos kadaghan, huwag ka dumog tingalian ng mga sermon karon. The Christian way of life is a super is a mental attitude life. Now I'm telling you that the Christian way of life is a mental attitude life. It's in the mind. What you are absorbing now is the Word of God, the mind of Christ, for you to use. Now, muntana ko nimo. Can you think without words? Nakaanhi ba si Ed karong hapuna? O guwapas yung iyo? O muapas ko nila? Kanang pa yun niya? O muapas ko nila? Buwag to ko? Di ba words na? Ganihang buntag, yung ka, diyan nagabaybahay na kag-words. Buwag to ko, buwatin ko sa Bible study. These are group of words which come to your mind, right? That's why the Christian life is a mental attitude life which you can use in your everyday life, moment by moment life with God. Now, the supernatural Christian way of life is accomplished only when we reside in the divine dynasphere, fulfilling the protocol plan of God. Ang awang ipanghiskutan, ang imong pagka-unique believer in the church age. Unique. Unique in the sense that you have a complete Bible. You have escrow blessings in store for you if you become a winner. You have historical impact as mature believers. Now, ang kabubuton sa Diyos na kitang mga magtutuo will become mature. Di gyud siya makabubo sa iyang mga blessings unless we become mature. Mao tayo ang iyong example ganiya, ang bata, tagaan yung auto, di siya maka-appreciate, di siya maka- You have no capacity. Do you think you'll be happy? You become miserable. That's why God wants us to have that capacity. And the only way that we can reach that capacity is to do what we are doing. Studying and studying and studying. Because my job here is to study, study and teach, study and teach, study and teach. You see? I have no way while you ko'y interes sa pag pahibaom kanang mahibaw ko unsay imong kinabuhi. That's your life. Because I respect your life. I respect your decision. God respects our volition. You see? God cannot force us. Ingan kita rin eh, because of volition. So, mao na ang punto nga akong gitaan mo diha. Nga, as mature believers, niya pa, ako lang yung ipa, dali. Once you become, by the way, how many stages that a believer passes? Stages. There are three major stages. Saman. Primero, he becomes a baby believer. Bago pa siyang dawat ni Kristo, baby believer. And then he become an adolescent, adult believer. Pumuhunong siya niya, adult na siya, bisa pag 80 years old na siya. Murag bata bang sige lang inyong mong bibiron. Nakita ko, tiguang dahil bibiron. Mauna ang pictures, a believer without growing. But what does the Word of God say? Grow in grace and in the knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ. Grow. And that's how to reach maturity. Grow. Make it as your priority. Study God's Word. Study God's Word. Hantod mahimog yung klaro ni mo siya. And then, diha sa adult, pag-adult ni mo, you reach maturity. Namon, nahingon ako ni mo na you have capacity for life. Saan mo pasabot niya yung capacity for life? Sige mo na kung hisgot niyo mo kay Bao. Capacity for life means, it is a stage nga, bisag unsa kahimtang sa imong kinabuhi, kapait ba, kahayahay ba, adversity or prosperity, okay lang. That's what we mean by capacity for life. You see? Job said, bisag pagkabahong na Job, kinagrabihan it. Oh, putong AIDS naman nga lito. Grabe si Job. Kung saan yung usulti? God give it. God take it away. Blessed be the name of God. Tanawa na. Satanas, di kung-kung. Di sura, di din si Job. He was a winner. You see? Siya ang ipakita sa Osaka karong panahon na nga. Then look at Job. He's a mature believer. Relax lang siya. See? Muna ang buod sa Diyos. Through adversity or prosperity, He wants us to have capacity for life. Capacity for blessings. Now, blessings, ang mga ganti o ang mga panalangin na ibubo sa Diyos. Naarabay panahon sa imo stage as you grow? O yung ka, ang kumutulang dumili. Aha, pabantay. Because you are growing in grace and in the knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ. That is a penalty for being a mature believer. Now, that's negative statement. It's supposed to be, that's what you deserve. God has been, ang Ginoo, parihar na siya, He's stopping His foot. Murang isigil na siya, nakukuwat ba? Kinsay akong anak na tagahan ako diyan na mayang tagahan na rin pagkiti. Sige, tubo lang. Mung niya tugihin mo. Patubuon ta. Patubuon. How can you receive your blessing if you are not growing, you are not making the Word of God as your priority? That's why this is a challenge to each one of us. Nining kagabihon. Nga kinigrasya raming tanan. Iyang gisangkap ka na ito. Huwag mag-yutay atuhan nini. Puro ramang yun nini. Okay, iyang pagsangkap. O, is the time already for us? It's getting late. Okay. Magdukota sa itong mga ulo. The closing moments of our worship service this afternoon. To those of you who are here right now without Christ, without hope, without eternal life,
You must have made many decisions in your lifetime. Perhaps you have never made that most important of all decisions, to personally believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord Jesus Christ bore in his own body on the cross every sin you have ever committed or ever will commit. By his death on the cross, he also made provision for you to become a Christian and to fulfill his plan for your life. There is nothing between you and God, not even sin, only your own rejection. By just a simple act of faith in Jesus Christ, you can be born again. You can become a child of God and a member of his royal family forever. You can possess eternal life right now. How? Whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. So this is your opportunity. You can offer a silent prayer by saying, Father, I am believing in Jesus Christ. I am receiving him as my Savior. He that believeth on the Son hath everlasting life, and he that believeth not the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abideth on him. Let us pray. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for that so great salvation which you have freely provided for us through your uniquely born Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Although we do not deserve your love because of our sinfulness and unfaithfulness to you, you have ever been faithful and always will be to your word. Make us always realize and be aware that you and your word are the only two immutables throughout the universe. And realizing that always, may we make these two immutables our priority in our present life, thus reaching our goal, which is spiritual maturity, the capacity for life, for blessings, and for happiness. We thank you, Father, for your wonderful protocol plan for each one of us, members of the royal family of God, which you have taught us in your word, a plan which is the best and the highest. We thank you for the fellowship which we have shown for each other this evening. The true doctrinal concept of Christian fellowship, which has developed within us as a result of doctrine resident in our soul. All these we ask in the name of our wonderful Lord Jesus Christ, our only Savior. Amen.